Michelle Glass here. Welcome back. Our topic for this presentation are the thoracic vertebrae. These are going to be located behind your thoracic cage. Does anyone remember how many of these we have? 12, that's right, because we eat lunch at 12 noon. Okay, now we still need to pick out those features that are common on all vertebrae, and then from there we are going to be naming the things that are specific about the thoracic and figuring out how to identify the thoracic vertebrae. Okay, now these are going to be named T1 to T12 because T is standing for thoracic and there are 12 of these. You are looking, remember, here is the anterior end and here's posterior, so it's going to be positioned in the body like this. You are looking here at the top of the vertebrae, so that's the superior view, and here is the inferior view. Okay. So we should be able to recognize some things already. So here is our vertebral body. We can see our neural arch forming our vertebral foramen, which is allowing space for the spinal cord. Notice how round it is. So that circular, round vertebral foramen is a good characteristic to help us pick out thoracic vertebrae. Okay, on the neural arch, remember you have the pedestal, which is the sides, and sticking off of that, you have your transverse foramen, and then you have your superior articular processes sticking up, and you have your flattened faces pointing towards the spinous process. So again, that's how you know that's pointing, the superior articular facets are pointing posteriorly. Here is your spinous process. See how it's curving sort of down? And notice that it's solid. It's not bifurcated. So that's our spinous process. Since we're looking at it in this view, you might see like a giraffe head. You see that? So that's also something, a little trick you can use to help you pick out thoracic vertebrae. Okay, so if these are the superior articular processes and superior articular facets, then remember directly underneath you have the inferior articular processes, and notice that the facets are pointing towards the body or anteriorly, so that's a good characteristic. And then remember your spinous process was hanging off the lamina, that's like the roof of the neural arch. Okay, the things that allow you to really know that you're looking at thoracic vertebrae, I've mentioned the circular vertebral foramen. I've mentioned that it sort of looks like a giraffe head, but the characteristics that are always good are looking for costal facets. You're gonna find three. You're gonna find it at the bottom of the vertebral body and at the top, and off the transverse process, and on both sides, here, here, and here. Those facets, remember, are these flat articular surfaces, and in the case here, you're going to have a rib that's going to be braced, attached to the body, braced by the transverse process, and coming around to the front. So sort of like that. Okay, and that is your thoracic vertebra.